So let's look closer on some selection tools highlights. So it will help a little bit better to work with a plant and hopefully optimize your workflow. So in this tutorial, you'll notice right here we have a preview already pre-created plant. We also have it a little bit more complex setup inside. Let me zoom kind of in. With nodes, it's a little bit more set up on for our plant. And we also have parameters on specific branches if we set up. What's happening if I want to select any specific plant? And for example, right here, I have a hard time to see where the leaves, what I need to work. And I can, of course, go and set up from graph. And for example, billboard, it's probably my leaves, I'm assuming, but it's hard to see. So let's do a look on some our options. You notice right here on top, we look, it's about hiding and display. For example, we can hide specific objects. We can hide blades, and we look on definition what blades it is, or billboards. So if I hide billboards, you notice right here, our leaves is disappear because we're using billboards for the leaves. Okay, we don't have any blades currently, but we have them in another plant and we can hide them. So it's help us to identify this way. Okay, we have let's hide all branches. Okay, and mostly branches when it's referred, it is referred to the some segments. Okay, blades again right here. Branches, and we can select the different type of the primitives. Next, we always can enable highlight on specific objects, so we select it. If I'm going to select trunks right here, you can see this is our main trunk from which we have a different type of the segments. And you remember, if you right click hold it, we can just select all of that group right here. So we can preview. Okay, let me go select maybe the other branches right at this point. And this also helped us identify on the graph which branch is actually working. So we know this will be our, this main branches that's going from our root. And this is a sub branches going from the sides. Okay, we also can enable by the color material if you have any specific, and currently right here is a node color. So I'm going and select, for example, this branch. And let's switch this maybe to some reddish color on a node. You notice right here we start highlighting them. So I'm going to select another branch and I want to change this to the blue kind of color. So in this case, I can preview specific components on the predefined colors. Okay, let me go select this branch, and just to be different, so we'll just select a little bit yellowish. In this case, I can see where's my components applied and how they work, so it's easy to identify them by the colors. Okay, we also have another options to look on wireframe, and currently, this is more apply wireframe to components with objects we included. So we can still see right here, but again, it's not with texture, it's not visible. So we'll enable again shading. And with the shades and the casting, it does give you a little bit more perspective on 3D. But again, if you think it's a bit destructive or it's also take a little bit of render time, you probably want to disable if you want it. However, I will leave it on. We also have it preview displacements if any displacements are applied, and preview in even normals, so we can preview the normals for this current plan. Okay, as a preview, this is a plant, and plant and view, they interact with the wind and breeze. We can enable our wind preview. And in some cases, it's actually very helpful because you can see some trunk, like right here, is too flexible to our wind. So we need increase on this trunk, respond less to the wind, a little bit more, maybe on a billboard, so you can adjust. And this is what very nice and helpful with preview of the wind. Okay, next we have a preview board figure, so we can preview the bone connection and how when it will be animated, so it will apply it. An hour meter. The next one is kind of interesting because this is show base control. In some case, think about these kind of effectors inside the view, how you can apply. For example, we can select our enable bases, so we can go click right there. And I'm going to enable directions, and you'll notice directions go string, so it's applied. If I want apply even very heavy, it will bring even more down. So right here we have a directional basis. Okay, or we can actually going in a negative, which is will going overall bring up. And of course we can modify directional apply as well. So this is more as a effectors that you can kind of readjust and see how they will affect or work with the specific. Again, if you work with Vue, with particles, and with you know, access, think about this kind of like a effectors, different type that you can kind of add more and apply different. I'm just going to very extreme type of the effect, so you can see right here start applied to us. Okay, let's delete that one. There we have a twirl applied. Okay, and we can disable them, so we don't have anything applied to our currently plant. Okay, so this is a preview options. You'll notice we also have our main gizmo that we can adjust. And let's still be here. Let's look on some other options we can apply it. And this is working with the branches with this, with cutting or drawing other ones. This is total different options inside the plant factory. So it's kind of growing. And let's look on this in our next tutorial.